If your intuition tells you that the incremental approach of the Ford-Fulkerson method produces a maximum flow, that's a good thing. Your intuition is correct. But it's important that it be correct for the right reasons. Not all incremental approaches work. Often in optimization, we get stuck in local minima or local maxima. We need to argue either that we never make a mistake, the analysis of greedy algorithms typically have this feel, or we need to be able to argue that the rules for incrementing allows us to undo any mistakes that we have made along the way. The latter will be the case for maximum flow. The argument we'll make is complex and will require us to introduce a new notion of a minimum cut in a graph along the way. But in the end, it's rewarding and provides an example of how to find elegance in analysis.
To show that Ford-Fulkerson returns a maximum flow, we're going to introduce the concept of a cut and then relate the capacity of a cut to a flow. Here's a picture of our understanding so far. We know that the network will have some possible non-negative flow values, but it's not exactly clear how high this range goes or where the results of Ford-Fulkerson fit in. One observation is that the flow value can't exceed the capacity of edges coming out of the source. Remember that the flow is defined to be the sum of the flows over these edges. Separating S from T in this way constitutes a cut in the graph, which, as we'll see, is an upper bound on the value of any flow. It's possible that there will be smaller cuts as well, which will shrink the range of possible flow values for us. Even better, however, we'll see that the flow produced by Ford-Fulkerson has the same value as a cut, and since this cut serves as an upper bound on all possible flows, this flow must be a maximum. That's where this argument will end up.